So now that Apple has finally caved and added trackpad and mouse support to their iPad, they're really trying to push their iPad as a legitimate laptop replacement, especially with their new iPad Pro and Magic Keyboard, which has a backlit keyboard, an extra USB-C port so that you can charge your iPad Pro, but still have an accessory connected to your iPad Pro at the same time. But more importantly, it also has a built-in trackpad, essentially transforming your tablet into a laptop that runs iPadOS. But unfortunately, the Magic Keyboard won't be available until later on. So if you want to get the laptop experience on your iPad Pro right now, you can either pair it up to the Smart Keyboard Folio and a Magic Trackpad or Magic Mouse. And yeah, after using this setup for the last week, I do think the iPad Pro can act as a laptop replacement for someone who is mostly browsing social media, consuming content like movies, videos, or books, and are mostly using word processing apps. But is it the smartest investment out there? I don't really think so. Now, this is the entry-level iPad Pro, which has an 11-inch screen, which is gorgeous, by the way, and it also has 128 gigs of internal storage, and this guy retails for $800. Now, if you were to add in the Smart Keyboard Folio, this thing retails for $180, and if you throw in a Magic Mouse like I did, that thing retails for $80. So the grand total of this setup comes out at $1,060. Plus tax. Or if we were to pair the iPad Pro to the Magic Keyboard, which retails for $300, then that hypothetical setup would cost $1,100. And mind you, this is simply the entry level pricing. For the same amount of money, you can literally get the new MacBook Air, which has a larger 13-inch screen and 256 gigs of internal storage, which is the double of that of this iPad Pro. But let's just say, hypothetically speaking, you're dead set on getting an iPad Pro because you want a lot of power in a very compact form factor. I still can't help but notice some usability shortcomings that just make me want to go right back to using a normal size 13-inch laptop. First off, you definitely gotta get used to using this smaller keyboard because it is noticeably more cramped than the full-size keyboard that you might find on a 13-inch MacBook Pro or the wireless keyboard that you might be used to using with your iMac. Now, I know a lot of people complain about the butterfly switches found on the 13-inch MacBook Pro, but the switches on the iPad Pro are just way worse because this is just straight up mush city. But eventually, you do learn to deal with it. But one of the biggest reasons why I miss using a laptop is because the Smart Keyboard doesn't allow you to fully adjust the angle of your screen. Now, yeah, the iPad is at a really good angle for whenever you're going to use it on a tabletop, but for when you're going to use it in bed. Now, let's be honest, a lot of people love using their laptop in bed. You can't fully customize the angle of the screen. Now, yeah, you can definitely just hold your iPad, but this does get tiring after a while. Now, one of the coolest things about this case is how it attaches to your iPad. It just magnetically connects. Now, even though, yeah, this is pretty cool and all, it's definitely not my favorite. I've already had a situation where I was opening my iPad and it just fell out and, you know, it got damaged. So if you're somebody that's accident prone, you definitely want to watch out, or you might want to look into a different case. Personally, I just think this is a sneaky way of Apple trying to get you to buy a new iPad Pro or for you to spend money at the Genius Bar getting your iPad Pro repaired. Now, when it comes to the mouse support on the iPad, I really don't have any complaints. Now, if you pair a Magic Mouse to the iPad Pro, it's like using your mouse with any other iMac. The cursor speed is about the same, you've got the same gestures, so you can scroll up and down, or you can swipe in between app pages, and the cursor is smart enough to enlarge certain elements whenever you get near them. Using a mouse on your iPad really does make it much easier to navigate through your iPad. Because personally, I've never been a fan of touchscreens on laptops in general. I feel that doing this requires a lot more work than just using a trackpad or a mouse. But what I did notice was that if you try to use a third-party mouse like the MX Vertical, it wasn't as seamless as using a Magic Mouse. My cursor speed was way too high and I didn't have a way to reduce it. And also, since you lose gesture support, it really is a handicap whenever you're trying to navigate through iPad OS. So hopefully in the near future, third-party companies like Logitech will put out an app for iPad so that you can customize your mouse and also set the hotkeys on your MX Vertical and MS Master 3. But when you put everything together, like the iPad Pro, Smart Keyboard, and Magic Mouse, I mean, you really can get some work done here. Now, like I mentioned earlier, typing on the smaller keyboard isn't the best, but you do learn to adjust. And since the iPad itself is very powerful, you can quickly jump in between apps and have multiple apps open because, you know, this thing does have 6 gigs of RAM. And thanks to the mouse support, you can quickly navigate through your pages and you can cut and paste stuff just like how you would with any other laptop. And like I mentioned earlier, the iPad Pro is great for consuming content like books or videos just because the screen on this thing is super vibrant. But also, the speakers on the iPad Pro sound really good as well. I'm even willing to go as far and say that the speakers on the iPad Pro sound better than the speakers on this 13-inch MacBook Pro. They sound fuller and they suffer from less distortion. But so that you can hear for yourself, we're gonna jump into a quick sound test. Also, the microphone on the iPad Pro and the front-facing camera make for great video calls because you look and sound great. So if you're somebody who works from home or if you're just trying to stay in touch with family, then the iPad Pro really does come in handy. But finally, let's talk about the new camera system on the back. You've got your 12 megapixel wide angle lens and you also get a new 10 megapixel ultra wide lens, which can be very useful for when you're trying to take pictures in a cramped room or if you're trying to get a large subject, you can get it without having to step so far back. Now, overall, I do think the camera on the iPad Pro gets the job done, but I don't think that the quality on the iPad Pro is as good of that of the iPhone XS Max, Pixel 4 XL, or Samsung Galaxy S20. I feel that the shots from the iPad Pro can be a little soft and they can definitely get very noisy. But you know what they say, the best camera is always the one that you have on you. But something that's really interesting on the iPad Pro is the new LiDAR system. Basically, what it does is that it allows for augmented reality elements to have a better footing whenever you're moving your iPad around. Because let's say with my iPhone XS Max, whenever I move around, the AR element might wiggle around a little bit and even resize. Whereas with the iPad Pro, the AR element is much better planted, since the iPad Pro actually has a much better understanding of its surroundings, it's able to better place an object and keep it true to size. Ultimately, what this new LiDAR system is, it's a tool for developers so that they can make better and more accurate augmented reality apps. They can either make better games or they can make more accurate tools for, like, let's say, previewing what furniture would look like in your home on a much more accurate scale. This LiDAR system isn't something that you'll be using on a regular basis, but it could possibly become a standard sensor in the near future because it's very likely that the next iPhone will also have a LiDAR system, thus accelerating the development of AR apps even more. But like I mentioned at the beginning of this video, I really do think the iPad Pro can act as a replacement laptop for people who mostly used their laptop for browsing social media, consuming content, and a lot of word processing. And, you know, to be frank, that's definitely a good chunk of people. But is it the best investment out there? I don't really think so. You can get the iPad Pro and pair it up to the smart keyboard and Magic Mouse, or you can get an entry-level iPad Pro and pair it up to a Magic Keyboard, but still end up paying MacBook Air prices. So I still feel that if you're looking for a laptop, get a laptop. I still feel that the iPad Pro and iPads in general are more like companion pieces that complement your full-on computer. Like, let's say, for example, me. I found that I really like using my iPad Pro because I can load up scripts on it, and I also really like using the iPad Pro as a secondary display with my iMac. And if you're a creative professional, then yeah, the iPad Pro can definitely be great for creative apps with an Apple Pencil. So overall, even though the iPad Pro is cool and all, I still feel that a proper laptop is the better long-term investment because it doesn't require any real compromises. If you made it this far, I guess you enjoyed the video, so hit that like button and get subscribed. It helps out more than you realize. If you want to pick any of the products up mentioned in this video, those will be linked in the description down below, and you can also support the channel by checking out the merch store. But other than that, I'll catch you next time.